The rumors regarding the upcoming RTX 5090 from Nvidia were always at an all-time high. But now recently, there are talks about the GPUs implementing faster GDDR7 VRAM. What does this mean for gamers and people who prefer to delve into graphics-intensive tasks in general? And more importantly, when can you expect to slot this behemoth of a GPU in your PC? Well, let's find out. The highlight and the main thing that everyone can't stop talking about is Nvidia's implementation of the GDDR7 VRAM. In layman's terms, this specific configuration can easily outpace the current models with blinding speeds of up to 28 Gbps. However, leakers still can't get any info regarding a specific bus width, so performance assumptions are still, well, assumptions and wishful thinking most of the time. For a lot of people, including ourselves, it's hard to look past the current wave of GPUs and imagine something more powerful. For starters, the RTX 4090 has been on the top of the food chain since 2022 and has been dominating ever since. If we analyze the release pattern, it wouldn't hurt to assume the next wave of GPUs to be released somewhere around the end of this year, and if we're lucky, the RTX 5000 series as well. These leaks, as always, came in hot courtesy of the ever-reliable, all-seeing Copite7 Kimmy, who mentioned explicitly how the next-gen lineup is about to arm themselves with GDDR7 chips, running at a staggering 28 Gbps. To show how much of an impact we're talking about, picture the RTX 4090 all the way down to the RTX 4070. And notice how all of them wield GDDR6X memory with a speed cap of 24 Gbps. If this isn't an upgrade, we don't know what is. Based on the current scenario, no one would blame you if, inside your head, you feel like the next-gen Nvidia cards would come with even greater memory capabilities, considering we've seen them pulling off more impressive feats before. If all goes well, it could result in PC setups that can handle an almost unreal level of texture details and incredible visuals, all running fluidly. The bus width, though, is something to be concerned about. But according to Copite7 Kimmy, 512-bit is still going to be on the cards, while mentioning previously how future flagships would be coming in with a 384-bit memory bus. Now, you might be wondering why memory bus width matters at all. And why are we making a big deal out of it? Well, if you wish to play the latest PC titles, bus width plays a big role in determining your overall performance. To put it simply, it ties to both the maximum capacity of the card and attributes like bandwidth. Take an RTX 5090, for example, that came with a 512-bit bus, in which case it can easily boast 48 GB of VRAM using 3GB modules, resulting in basically you never needing to worry about performance, for at least a few years anyway. However, do keep in mind it's only a leak, and everything tastes better with a bit of salt. While the leak is anything but official, the chatter nonetheless provides a pretty interesting and captivating insight into what the next step for Nvidia could look like. Especially when you think about the performance. We don't know about you, but we can't wait to see what's up Nvidia's sleeve. And if all goes well, we'll get to see all that in details, only comparable to the highest caliber of graphical qualities rendered by Nvidia themselves. And that is no small feat by a long shot. Regardless, what are your thoughts and opinions on the overall situation and leaks? And what are you expecting from Nvidia? Do let us know, as we'd love to hear from you. And as for everything else, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell icon if you want more content like this on your feed.